In this video, we'll learn how to use basic pixel brush settings in Adobe Fresco. The pixel brush is one of three brush types that we have access to. Pixel brushes are probably what you'll be most used to if you've had any experience working in Photoshop and many other tablet-based digital drawing apps. And if we tap on the pixel brush icon in the top of the toolbar, you can see a range of different brush settings to choose from. Now, there's a lot here, and each one of these categories contains multiple different similar brushes. I'll post a link in the description to a handy chart that gives you an idea of which type of brush is best for which situation. Now, by default, we're going to start off in the sketching subcategory with the pencil. For any of these brush types, we can click on them and click the star, and that will add them to our favorites. You can see I've already favorited a couple here. I'll just go ahead and reselect our pencil brush since that's what we'll start off working with. So let's click that pixel brush icon one more time. And to start off, I'd like to experiment with some of the options we have available to us when using the Apple Pencil. So I'll go ahead and start to draw a shape here. And I'm imagining maybe this is a piece of fruit, maybe an apple or a pear. I can change the quality of my line a little bit just by varying the amount of pressure that I'm placing on the screen. So you can see here at the top, the line's a little bit thinner and lighter than it is at the bottom, and that's because I was using different pressures for those parts of the image. Now, in addition to pressure, we can also vary the angle of the Apple Pencil in relationship to the screen. So if I come at it with a sort of sideways approach, I can start to do some nice subtle shading here. Maybe a little bit more right there. And you know, I'm imagining the light is coming from this direction, so we can do a little bit of a shadow here. Now, of course, just like any of the drawing tools in Fresco, we have the option of adjusting the color through the color picker. Now, we'll cover the ins and outs of this interface in a different video, but notice here I've already saved out a few swatches for myself, so I'm going to go ahead and switch to this sort of darker brown that's fully opaque. And let's just give ourselves a little bit more shading down here in the bottom where it's going to be real dark. And so you can see how both the pressure and the angle of the Apple Pencil interact with each other to help me vary basically the amount of material that I'm applying to the canvas as well as the width of the stroke. Let's take a look at some of the detailed settings we have here in our tool options panel. So we've got our color picker, and right below that, we've got our brush size. So I've got this slider here, and I can vary this bigger or smaller, and I get a little preview of the brush diameter in this window. So now I can get a nice wide stroke, a little bit similar to what I was getting from varying the angle. This just gives me a little bit more precision. Right below our brush size is a dialog to set the flow. So flow is basically the amount of simulated material that we're adding to the current layer. And when we're using a pencil, the flow equates to basically the hardness of the pencil. So a higher flow is going to simulate a softer pencil. A lower flow is going to simulate a harder pencil. So let's try a little bit of a flow experiment here. I'll take my flow down really low to something like 12. And I probably want a slightly smaller brush size here. So you can see a different quality of the line when my flow is low. Let's go ahead and undo that. And let's try that again with a higher flow. And that's looking a little bit more like what I'd want in this image. The next setting we'll take a look at is our smoothing. So this is how much we're asking Fresco to smooth out the little wobbles that might be in our hand as we're drawing. Right now, my smoothing is set very high to 97. Let's take this down all the way to zero so we're not getting any smoothing at all. And let's just scooch this over. I'll do a similar sort of a fruit shape here. Maybe this one's going to be a pear. And so you can see here, you know, I get some wobbles here, picking up the slight motions in my hand. And maybe that's a quality that I'd like. On the other hand, maybe I want something a little bit smoother, like this outline that I drew with my smoothing dialed all the way up. Last but not least, we'll take a look at our brush settings, and we can find those at the bottom of our tool options panel. So I'll click this button and we get an additional dialog for lots more very detailed settings. We'll cover those in more detail in a separate video, but a couple things to pay attention to here that are really nice are this little trial area. So this lets us test out the quality of our line as we're changing our settings here. I can adjust things like the blend mode, so that is how my colors will interact with what's below them, as well as what I'd like to happen as I vary the pressure and the speed of my line. One thing I'd like to take a look at here is Stylus Pressure, and this lets you adjust how sensitive your tablet is to the pressure of your hand. So if you're someone like me who's pretty heavy-handed, you might want to dial this up to heavy. Or if you're someone who draws very lightly, you might want to draw this back down to light. Now the good news is we can change this at any time. We can even customize it by grabbing these little control handles here and really fine-tuning how we'd like the screen to respond to our hand. We get another test area here. So I can see this is, for me, that's way too sensitive. So I'm going to dial this up to heavy. And that's much better. That is a nice quick overview of how to use some of the basic pixel brush settings in Adobe Fresco.